dear brothers and sisters in Christ. So, I am now going to post the part 8. I hope that is the last part of the Book of Revelation. And then after that, I will post the visions, because they were all shown in visions about the apocalyptic events. So here you go.
Flesh of kings, rulers, leaders, horses, riders, free people, slaves, important people, and everyone else. I also saw the beast and all kings of the earth come together. They fought against the rider of the white horse and against his armor. But the beast was captured, and so was the false prophet. This is the same prophet who had worked miracles for the beast, so that he could fool everyone who had the mark of the beast and worship the idol. The beast and the false prophet were thrown alive into a lake of burning sulfur. But the rest of their army was killed by the sword that came from the mouth of the rider on the horse. Stuffed themselves in the dead bodies. I saw an angel come down from heaven, carrying the key to the deep pit and the big chain. He chained the dragon for 1,000 years. That old snake, who is also known as the devil and Satan. Then the angel threw the dragon into the pit. He locked and sealed it, so that 1,000 years would go by before the dragon could fool the nations again. But after that, it would have to be set free for a little while. I saw thrones, and sitting on those thrones were the ones who had been given the right to judge. I also saw the souls of the people who had their heads cut off, because they had told about Jesus and preached God's message. They were the same ones who had not worshipped the beast or the idol. They had refused to let its mark be put in their hands or foreheads. They will come to life and rule with Christ for 1,000 years. These people are the first to be raised to life, and they are especially blessed and holy. The second death has no power over them. They will be priests for God and Christ, for 1,000 years. No other dead people were raised to life until 1,000 years later. At the end of 1,000 years, Satan will be set free. He will fool the countries of Gog and Magog, which are at the far ends of the earth, and their people will follow him into battle. They will have as many followers as there are grains of sand along the beach. They will march all the way across the earth. They will surround the camp of God's people and the city that his people love. Fire will come down from heaven and destroy the whole army. sitting on it. Earth and heaven tried to run away, but there was no place for them to go. I also saw all the dead people standing in front of that throne. Every one of them was there, no matter who they had once been. Several books were opened, and then the Book of Life was opened. The dead were judged by what those books said they had done. The sea gave up the dead people who were in it. Death and its kingdom also gave up their dead. Then everyone was judged by what they had done. Afterwards, death and its kingdom were thrown into the lake of fire. This is the second death. Anyone whose name wasn't written in the Book of Life was thrown into the lake of fire. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared, and so had the sea. Then I saw New Jerusalem, that holy city, coming down from God in heaven. It was like a bride dressed in her wedding gown and ready to meet her husband. I heard a loud voice shout from the throne, "God's home is now with his people. He will live with them, and they will be his own. Yes, God will make his home among his people. He will wipe all tears from their eyes, and there will be no more death, suffering, crying, or pain. These things of the past are gone forever." Then the one sitting on the throne said, "I am making everything new. Write down what I have said. My words are true and can be trusted. Everything is finished. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will freely give water from the life-giving fountain to everyone who is thirsty. All who win the victory will be given these blessings. I will be their God, and they will be my people. But I will tell you what will happen to cowards and to everyone who is unfaithful, or dirty-minded, or who murders, or is sexually immoral, or uses witchcraft, or worships idols, or tells lies. They will be thrown into that lake of fire and burning sulfur. This is the second death." I saw one of the seven angels who had the bowls filled with the seven last terrible troubles. The angel came to me and said, "Come on. I will show you the one who will be the bride and wife of the Lamb." Then with the help of the Spirit, he took me to the top of a very high mountain. There he showed me the holy city of Jerusalem, coming down from God in heaven. The glory of God made the city bright. It was dazzling and crystal clear, like a precious jasper stone. The city had a high and thick wall, south, and the other three were on the west. each of the stones was written the name of one of the Lamb's 12 apostles. The angel who spoke to me had a gold measuring stick to measure the city and its gates and its walls. The city was shaped like a cube because it was just as high as it was wide. When the angel measured the city, it was about 1,500 miles high and 1,500 miles wide. Then the angel measured the wall, and by our measurements, it was about 216 feet high. The wall was built of jasper. The city was made of pure gold, clear as crystal. Each of the 12 foundations was a precious stone. The first was jasper. The second was sapphire. The third was agate. The fourth was emerald. The fifth was onyx. The sixth was carnelian. The seventh was chrysolite. The eighth was beryl. The ninth was topaz. The tenth was chrysoprase. The 11th was jacinth. And the 12th was amethyst. Each of the 12 gates was a solid pearl. The streets of the city were made of pure gold, clear as crystal. I did not see a temple there. The Lord God all-powerful and the Lamb were its temple. And the city did not need the sun. Nations will walk by the light of that city, and kings will bring their riches there. Its gates are always open during the day, and night never comes. The glorious treasures of nations will be brought into the city. But nothing unworthy will be allowed to enter. No one who is dirty-minded or who tells lies will be there. Only those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life will be in the city. The angel showed me a river that was crystal clear, and its waters gave life. Never again will night appear, and no one who lives there will ever need a lamp or the sun. The Lord God will be their light. They will rule forever. Then I was told that these words are true and can be trusted. The Lord God controls the spirits of his prophets, and he is the one who sent his angel to show his servants what must happen right away. Remember, I am coming soon.
So this will be continued, the last part with visions.